In this screencast, I'm going to be showing you all about the binomial distribution. I'm going to show you how to derive it, and I'm also going to go through an example. So the binomial distribution is a type of discrete distribution function. We're generally talking about trials where you can have a probability of success and a probability of failure. You can only have two options. It can either be a success or a failure. Most of the time, we refer to P as the probability of an individual success. And I'm just going to, you know, work through an example where a probability of a success of an individual trial might be 0.7. If this were coin flipping, the probability of getting a heads, if we call that a success, would be 0.5. And we also have a failure. Sometimes failures are denoted by Q, which is 1 minus P. So in this case, it would be 0.3. Let's just assume we have 5 trials. There are a couple ways that we could do this, and we're saying, all right, well, how many ways can we have 3 successes, or what's the probability of having 3 successes? And we go a little bit further, what's the probability of having exactly 3 successes? Well, if we have 5 trials, we can denote those as 5 different spaces here. So how many different ways can we have 3 successes? So I'm going to denote successes by S. So I can have success, 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 failure, failure. If I had that, what would be the probability that that would occur? Well, we just take the probability of success, and we're going to cube that, basically, because we have 3 successes. But then we need to multiply by the probability of failure, which is 0.3, because those 3 successes are followed by 2 failures. So this then would be the probability of this exact arrangement, and you have to keep that in mind. However, if I'm just asking for in 5 trials, what's the probability that I have exactly 3 successes? There are other arrangements that we can consider. So I could have a success, success, failure, success, failure. And that too would have the same exact probability. So 0.7 cubed times 0.3 squared. Or in general, I could write this as p cubed and 1 minus p squared for 5 trials. But we can have tons of different ways that we could write this. I could write failure, success, 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 failure. You might be thinking, okay, well, that then is just the number of ways that we could have 3 successes put into 5 spots would be, we have 5 spots and we're going to choose 3 of them to be successes. And a lot of times we'll write that 5, choose 3. If I have a bunch of different ways that I can write or arrange the successes and failures, each of those independent arrangements, and there will be, in this case, 5, choose 3, each arrangement is adding to our total probability of having 3 successes in 5 trials. The total probability of having exactly 3 successes then would be the total number of ways that we can arrange those 3 successes in 5 different trials times the probability of any given one of those arrangements being the way it is. So in this case, it's 5 choose 3 times 0.7 cubed times 0.3 squared. And that's the overall probability. And with probability functions, we would write this as f of 3 is going to be that. In general, we can write the binomial distribution if we have n trials and x successes. Remember, we're talking about exactly x successes. We're not talking about at least x successes. So the f of x probability is equal to n choose x, the probability of a success to the x number of trials, times 1 minus p to the n minus x. So I've got an example here. You work for a pharmaceutical company that makes a pharmaceutical product named Curezol. 5.3% of all batches are failures. What is the probability that 17, and exactly 17, out of 20 batches will be successful? We're going to use the binomial distribution, and we use this binomial distribution function because we have a probability of success and a probability of failure. We're looking at successes here. Our probability, 5.3%, is actually not a success. This is a probability of failure. So the probability of success then would be 94.7%. We have a total number of 20 trials. We want x to be 17. So I can use the binomial distribution. F of 17 is just going to be the following. And if you plug this into your calculator or do this on a computer, this will end up being 0.067. Now, what if I were to ask, what is the probability that at least 17 out of 20 batches will be successful? This, the way it's written, is exactly 17. So if I said, what's the probability that at least 17 out of 20 would be successful? That would be F of 17 plus F of 18 plus F of 19 plus the probability that all 20 of 20 are successful. If you plug those values for X into binomial distribution, instead of 17, we have 18, 19, or 20. And instead of 3, we have 2, 1, or 0. You would get the following. If you tally those up, you would get 98%. So you have a 98% chance that at least 17 out of 20 batches will be successful.